Over the weekend, Hugh Jackman released this little beauty on Instagram and set the internet aflutter. It seems pretty straightforward. We've got just one hand with the Wolverine claws, seeming to indicate the number 3, which would be perhaps the third Wolverine film, which is coming up in 2017. And then because this is Instagram, he didn't write a lot with the picture. He was, you know, succinct and to the point, and he just wrote with it, Wolverine, one last time, HJ. And so everybody immediately jumped to the conclusion that this was a message from Hugh Jackman telling the world, telling his fans, that he was going to have one last outing as the character with that 2017 third Wolverine movie. Now, I, of course, being the huge Wolverine and Hugh Jackman fan that I am, I even didn't like his casting initially, but over the course of the franchise, he's really won me over both with his dedication and his professionalism. I decided that this was untrue, that everybody was jumping to conclusions too hastily, and that what he really meant by this photo was that he was doing the Old Man Logan storyline, and that it was one last time from the mind of Wolverine, you know, one last hurrah, as is the case with the Old Man Logan story. So that was my little bit of denial there, but as the weekend progressed and the story grew and got a lot of momentum and you saw the headline everywhere, and Hugh Jackman remained mum and did not correct anyone on this, what I hoped had been a misassumption, it became clear that it in fact was what he was saying. You know, maybe there's still room for a correction, but I think once the story gains this kind of momentum and everyone just, you know, internalizes, okay, this is the last one, I think it's hard to turn around and go, oh, just kidding, or you got it wrong, surprise, I'm going to stick around forever. I just don't think you can do that. So because he was quiet about how the story developed and how the picture was interpreted, I think this is the real deal. So because of that, it raises 3 questions, which we're going to address right now. And I'd be very curious to hear your answers to these questions in the comments down below. Now, the first one, obviously, is, why would he do such a thing? And I think that the timing here is no accident, that it comes very close to Jennifer Lawrence just last week saying that the third X-Men, her third X-Men outing, Apocalypse, would be her final turn as Mystique. And I think that Hugh Jackman probably said, hey, you know, if Jennifer Lawrence is getting off of this train and, you know, Patrick Stewart's kind of wrapping things up, et cetera, et cetera, I don't want to be the only one from the old guard left at the party, you know, when the party becomes uncool. So I think that, you know, you always want to leave on your own accord and not be booted out because everyone says you've suddenly become so bad in the role or you're too old for it. So I think that's one aspect there. Now, speaking of being too old, I think that Bryan Singer has not done Hugh Jackman any favors by casting the new characters in this upcoming film, X-Men Apocalypse, so young. You know, Hugh Jackman, of course, obviously is in great shape. He proved it in X-Men Days of Future Past, going, you know, doing the full Monty as Wolverine. He's like, still got it. And he did still have it. But I think, you know, he's 46, so he'll be about 48 when they make this final, you know, supposed final Wolverine film in 2017. But at 46, he's about 10 years older than Fassbender and McAvoy, and then far older than the new Jean Grey, the new Cyclops, the new Storm, and then the only person really there is Channing Tatum, who's also much younger than Hugh Jackman. And there comes a point where if you're standing next to all these much younger actors, then you're going to seem a lot older than Hugh Jackman actually seems. I think Hugh Jackman's in fantastic shape, but, you know, you can only be in such good shape. Now, also speaking of Jean Grey, you can see how this all just bleeds into it. Maybe this was Hugh Jackman's thought process after he got the news about Jennifer Lawrence. It just sent him on a journey, and he was like, should I still be Wolverine? And this was his thought process. So then you've got Jean Grey, who's Sophie Turner. She's like half his age or something. I think that totally robs him of one of Hugh Jackman's favorite subplots, and that's his unrequited romance with Jean Grey. He got a lot of mileage out of that. I think it's something that a lot of us have really enjoyed watching. The comics got a lot of mileage out of that. But I think, you know, some actors would be like, bring it on, I'll romance Sophie Turner, whatever. It's worked a lot really well for Littlefinger, right? But I think Hugh Jackman, as I said, I think he's deep down a pretty wholesome guy. He's, a really wonderful, kind person. And I think that's just something maybe he doesn't feel comfortable with. Also, to quote Ewan McGregor, you know, when they make the actresses younger and younger, you know, it's harder and harder to do the romantic scenes because it just points out how much older you look. Some actors like Tom Cruise don't believe that. They're like, cast him as young as he can because then everybody will think I'm the same age. And it doesn't work. So I think that by taking Jean Grey away from him, they've taken a lot out of this franchise that Hugh Jackman personally really is into. I mean, you might recall in, the Wolverine, the last Wolverine movie, he was really, he produced that and he wanted to make sure Jean Grey came back. And then even though he has his love with Mariko, etc., Jean Grey is still his dream girl. In this case, literally, she was his dream girl. So I think that that's the problem there. Now, some of you might be saying, hey, what are you talking about? So what if he's close to 50 when he films The Wolverine in 2017 or when it comes out? Robert Downey Jr. is older than Hugh Jackman is right now, and so is Johnny Depp. So is Tom Cruise. And these guys have no problem continuing with their respective franchises. Well, this is where a little bit of brilliance seeps in. So that's the next question. Should he do such a thing? So we've already covered why would he do such a thing. Now we're on to should he do such a thing. Now on the surface you go, what are you doing, Hugh Jackman? This is the only successful thing you've got going for you. Now, this was a fantastic break for him when he got cast as Wolverine. He was a nobody. It was his third film he ever made, his first Hollywood movie. He only got it because Doug Ray Scott became unavailable from the shooting schedule from Mission Impossible, the Mission Impossible franchise. He was the villain in the second film. So Hugh Jackman got called up. Overnight star, so well received in the role, and he really made it his own. However, in all the years that have passed since his first X-Men movie as Wolverine, he hasn't been able to really find success in any other genre or film. Really, flop after flop after flop. Look at even now, Chappie. Fantastic film, by the way, but Hugh Jackman, is he hurting it? Because, you look at his box office track record and he just simply cannot get films off the ground if they're not an X-Men movie. With an X-Men movie, he's all you need. But outside of the X-Men franchise, he is not enough. He has had Les Mis, and he was Oscar nominated for that. But at the same time, I think Anne Hathaway really ran away with that movie. And I think, well, Hugh Jackman got a lot of respect for Les Mis. I don't really think it's something that people are like, when are you going to do your next musical, Hugh? Oh, I can't wait for it. No, they're like, when are you going to be Wolverine again? It's not a successful adventure for him. Now, he does have some interesting movies on the horizon. Pan, I think that looks really compelling. I think he looks great in it, but we'll see. I think Pan is a bit of a wild card. It looks really good. It'll be interesting. Universal had some success with Snow White and the Huntsman, but so far really only Disney has really done well consistently with the live action fairy tale. And then also you've got the whitewashing issue with Tiger Lily that could have a backlash towards the film. It just might not work out. It's a very crowded summer movie season. We'll see how Pan fares, but he's got that. But he's not going to continue with it, I think, obviously, because he's not Hook or Pan. So I wouldn't be surprised if his character Blackbeard gets out of that movie alive. But then also he has the greatest show on earth, his big circus musical that Fox is, putting together for him because he's their Wolverine. They might be like, well, we don't know if we want to do that anymore if you're going to quit. But he does have, Apocalypse left over. Maybe he'll make some cameos in some other X-Men movies to be a team player. He was in Night at the Museum. He had a cameo. That was pretty awesome for him to do for Fox. And then he has the final Wolverine movie. So they're like, okay, we'll still make your musical. But on top of all that, where does it get brilliant? This is where I think it gets brilliant. And I was like, oh, Hugh, are you clever like a fox? If he quits the X-Men franchise, well, he's still a pretty viable actor, and he's still on the same level as Tom Cruise, Robert Downey Jr., Johnny Depp. He's potentially available now for another franchise. He can still get another one in there, and that's very exciting, especially with all the franchise work that's coming about. Everybody wants a franchise now. Everybody wants a cinematic universe. And while it's unlikely he'd jump over to Marvel because he was at Fox Marvel, I see no reason Star Wars couldn't pick him up, or Avatar, or they're even thinking of doing a Transformers franchise. He could easily jump into one of those. I would want him to go into Star Wars, and I think Star Wars would be lucky to have him, because they know he's such a fan favorite in this type of film. So I would be interested in giving him a call if I were producing one of those franchises, and I think Hugh Jackman would be interested in taking that call. So now what's the third question? This one doesn't have to do with Hugh Jackman. This has to do with the X-Men franchise. What should the X-Men franchise do? Now obviously, the biggest question is, should they recast? And with Jennifer Lawrence and Mystique, I feel they should definitely recast. I don't think she should be able to hold that character hostage. I don't think she's had nearly the run that Hugh Jackman has had as Wolverine. I think she's quitting because she doesn't like being Mystique, as I think is the vibe whenever she's on screen in those films. I think you can tell she's really uncomfortable. As I've said before, I'd like to think she's just that good an actress, and because Mystique is very uncomfortable in her own skin, at least at this point in her life when Lawrence is playing her, but I don't think so. I think she just does not like the role. So I think that I would recast Mystique, and also Mystique is a shapeshifter, so it's okay. But with Wolverine, and because Hugh Jackman is so much embodies the character, I'm not saying never recast it, but you can't recast it immediately. And I'm sure that Marvel, by the way, will be watching this very closely to see how Fox handles it, because they might very likely find themselves in the same situation soon with Robert Downey Jr. Although, I don't think Robert Downey Jr., especially considering the judge crashing and burning, will ever quit the Marvel films, as long as there's a big paycheck attached. So anyway, what I would do with the X-Men franchise is I would have Wolverine die, I'd kill him off, death of Wolverine, major storyline, and then I'd make it mean something because the character would be gone for a while. Not just, oh, he's back again, boop! Comic book deaths never really matter these days. Have him go away for a couple of years, we're talking about here. And you should be able to do that in the X-Men franchise because you have so many great characters, right? Now, that's where the other problem comes in. What great characters? Bryan Singer has done very little to build in a safety net for this franchise. Maybe perhaps because he felt that Hugh Jackman would never leave him. After all, he did make Hugh Jackman a star, right? And also, you have to wonder, with Lawrence leaving and now Hugh Jackman, what will this do for Fassbender and McAvoy, and perhaps even Channing Tatum? He's like, I just got to this party. What, you're all leaving? So those guys might be like, I don't know if I want to stick around anymore. And so I would hope their contracts have them built in for a couple of films. And if they don't, I would be slotting that contract in front of them about right about now if I were Fox, being like, I'd just like you to sign it for like 3 or 4 more movies, just to make sure. Because those are really your heavyweights that you have right now. These new actors, you know, they have to make an impression. And if I were Fox, I'd be calling up Singer. Thank goodness they haven't shot Apocalypse yet. And I'd be like, look, I know you like Hugh Jackman, but I want you to dial down the Wolverine scenes. He's leaving as it is. You know, I still have him be a big part of the movie because that's what people are paying to see. But you need to build me another star. You've got to make Sophie Turner really wow people as Jean Grey. Can you do anything with Ty Sheridan as Cyclops? You know, Cyclops really should be the character to take over this franchise. And they refused ever to cast a viable actor in that role. Look what the comics have done with Cyclops. It's been a fascinating ride ever since he merged with Apocalypse. That should be happening in this movie. But it's not going to, because there's no Cyclops for us to see damaged, to see broken, because he hasn't been established as the Boy Scout. And it's just, you know, James Marsden is a great comedian. He was horribly cast as Cyclops. I think Ty Sheridan was the wrong way to go, too young. And they really should have cast someone that could have been, you know, contemporary to Hugh Jackman and really been, you know, the yin to his yang, the two sons of Xavier and the two different things they took away from Xavier. So many great storylines just to the wind because of poor casting and weird changes in continuity with these two different timelines and creating situations where you have characters that are supposed to be the same age being significantly different ages. So we can't have Cyclops, but maybe they'll bring somebody else in. And it also underscores that they should have gone after Lupita Nyong'o for Storm, because how is Alexandra Shipp going to carry a movie? I hope she surprises us. Maybe, you know, after X-Men Apocalypse comes out, I'll be like, she can totally do it. But right now, I don't have a lot of faith in that. So I think Singer was careless. I think that he should have built in, safety nets, as I said, into this franchise in case anyone were to leave. But they better hold on to Fassbender, McAvoy, and Tatum, and then build up new stars, because they're going to need them once March 2017 rolls around. So those are my three answers to the question. I'm very curious to what you think they are, and I'm excited to discuss this news with you down below. And just also, what does this mean for the X-Men franchise in general? Is it viable post-Hugh Jackman? And is Hugh Jackman viable without the X-Men franchise? They really do have quite the symbiotic relationship. All right, thank you so much for tuning in. Again, write your thoughts down below. You can check out some other episodes right now.